So Adobe's just sneaked a few little features into Photoshop that makes it a lot easier now to cut out hair. Let me show you how it works. Hey, it's Colin Smith from Photoshop Cafe. Let's jump in and cut out some hair. So we're going to use this image from Adobe stock. It's got lots of curly hair, which is quite tricky, but I'll show you how to do it. So the first thing that we do in the year 2021 or beyond is grab our object selection or quick selection. Then you're going to see select subject. Now I've shown you this many times before, but let's go ahead and choose select subject. So it's basically two parts in cutting out hair. The first one is making the selection, which is sort of the easier part. The hard part is getting those edges clean. So as you can see, it's looking pretty good. I'm just gonna grab my quick select tool here because I wanna make sure that her shirt gets included in there. So all you need to do is just paint over those areas that you wanna include that are obvious. So we've selected the hair. Next step is to refine it. So we're gonna choose select and mask. In order to view how well our selection's going, since we've got a light colored background, let's go under view and change this to on black. Okay, now we can see the problems. So, first new feature is refine hair, but there's newer ones than that, but let's choose refine hair. Notice that does a nice job of starting to select it. Now we can go in here and manually fix this a little bit using this refine brush if there's some areas that have been missed, such as these areas of white. All right, here's where the magic happens. We've still got a little bit of white fringing around here, and sometimes it can be colored, but what we want to do is just go all the way down to the bottom and you see an option called Decontaminate Colors. Now, when you turn this on, it gets rid of the fringes, but notice how it almost looks cartoony. Here's a new feature. I don't know if you guys noticed it, but there's a slider called Amount. So if we take this amount all the way to the bottom, notice it's not doing any fading, but then as we increase it just a little bit, we can dial in exactly how much we want. And at this point, we just do new layer with layer mask, click OK. And you'll notice a layer mask in here. Now you can go into the layer mask and paint in there and do further refinements and get it perfect. But as you can see, we got 95% of the way there just by simply clicking a couple of those buttons. These new AI tools that Adobe is using are amazing for saving time. So I'm curious, you guys know about those options? Let me know in the comments underneath, and also let me know what you'd like to see me cover next week. And by the way, if you're new, welcome to Photoshop Cafe. It's great to have you with us. Consider hitting the subscribe button and turn on notifications so you don't miss any of my tutorials. And if you guys like this, do me a favor, hit that like button. It helps us with the YouTube algorithm. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.